Let's talk about different O-rings and how you can measure their size. You may have noticed that when you have an O-ring kit, that often has a three-digit number next to each O-ring. That three-digit number is referring to an SAE code. It's AS568 that actually will tell you the size of industrial O-rings. There are several ways you can measure them. There are charts where you can match them up, or in some cases there's a tool that looks like a very large funnel that has steps on it that you can place the O-ring over. Those tools are rather expensive, sometimes hundreds of dollars. There's also this sliding O-ring gauge, which we're going to demonstrate today. This is a much lower cost tool, generally under $100. In fact, we have a link in the description below where it can be purchased. The first digit of that three-digit code is referring to the thickness, or if you like, cross-section of the O-ring. On this tool, it has several notches at the top, so you will take the O-ring that you want to measure and determine which notch, or the smallest notch, that it will fit in. So this goes in this notch here, which is telling us that this first digit of the O-ring is going to be a 1, based on the cross-section or thickness. On this tool, there are two different pegs. The top peg will split apart, so you'll place the O-ring over that. If it is large enough to reach the bottom peg, you can hook it there and then read that scale. This one, as you can see, is not that large. So we're going to open it up and keep it hooked on both those pegs. Slide this open until the O-ring is straight on the sides. Now, especially with the thinner diameter O-rings, you do not want to stretch them. You just want to move it till it's straight. And then look in the appropriate window, which in our case is going to be the one showing two halves, because that's what we're on. We're not on the half and a whole peg. So if you look in this window, you can see that this O-ring, when it is pulled straight, measures as a 1.58. You can see in that small window there, it's 1.58. If the O-ring is too small to fit over this, you would simply match it up to the silhouette shown on the side of the tool. Let's do another O-ring. This one's a little thicker, but smaller diameter overall. We'll match that in the top. And here we have our thickness. We're going to put it over the two halves, pull it till it is straight, and then once again read our measurement in the window. You have two windows. This one is if you're using the bottom peg and the top half. We are using the top and lower half. So we're going to read out of this window, and this one would measure as a 222 O-ring, would be the size, 222. This can help us match up O-rings to sizes without trying several or having a supply of them. So they can be ordered online or however you would need to. This is the next size larger. That would fit in this groove. Longer O-ring, do the same. Now these are hard to stretch because of their size, but when I pull it straight, you can see that this one measures as a 365. There are actually, in this case, there's multiple 365s on the scale to make up for different tension amounts that you may be pulling. And our last O-ring, which is the thickest, is going to begin with a 4. Put that over the two halves. Pull that until it is straight on the sides. And it looks like this would be a 431 O-ring, would be the size. So this is a handy tool, fits in a compact space, can measure a wide variety of O-rings, and can be very helpful to determine what O-ring size you need without having a kit with every possible size available. So hopefully this helps when you're measuring O-rings for hydraulics.